Welcome to your computer science class. Today we will learn lesson number 6, more on MS PowerPoint 2010. So let us have a look at the topics we will study from this lesson. Children, from this lesson we will learn about slide layout, we will study about inserting pictures, slide views, inserting word art, and finally we will learn about inserting smart art. So children, these are the topics we have to study from lesson number 6, more on MS PowerPoint 2010. So let us have a look at the topics we will study today from this lesson. Children, from this lesson we will learn today about the slide layout, we will learn about inserting word art, and finally we will learn about inserting pictures from clip art. So children, these are the topics we have to study. So let us begin with the very first topic from the lesson, that is slide layout. Let us see what a slide layout is. Children, slide layout refers to the way the things are arranged on a slide. A layout contains placeholders which hold text such as titles, bulleted lists, and slide content such as tables, charts, pictures, shapes, and clip art. The layout is changed from the slides group in the Home tab. Now, before we understand about the slide layout, it is very important to know about what a slide is. Children, just as every single page in MS Word is known as a document, the same way every single page in PowerPoint is known as a slide. And the appearance of the slide is known as the layout. So let us understand how to change the layout. Suppose you can see here, this is the layout or the appearance of the slide. So to change the appearance or the layout, what we will do, I'll go to the Home tab, click on the slides group. You can see here the slides group, the layout option is given here. Click on the layout option. As soon as you will click on the layout option, you will get a list of 9 pre-designed slides. And the very first one is the title slide. Title and content, the second one, section header, to content, comparison, title only, blank slide, content with caption, picture with caption. So these are the 9 types of pre-designed slides in the layout tab. See here, this is the blank layout. Suppose if you want, this is a blank slide. If you want to create a new slide, from the slides group itself, you will keep here. In the thumbnail, press the mouse button below the slide where you want to insert a new slide. Create a new slide. Okay, suppose if you want a blank slide, right? Now, this is a blank slide. You want to change the layout of this slide. What you will do? You will go to the slides group, click on the layout option. Now, as there are 9 types of pre-designed slide, what you will do? You will click on the any one of the slides which you want. Okay, so this way we can change the layout of the slide. You can change here the appearance of the text. Again, if you want to change the appearance, see here, click on the title and content. You can see here, notice the changes in the layout of the slide. So this was about the layout of the slides. Now come to the next topic, that is word art. What is a word art, children? Word art is what? Word art gives a unique look to the text, to your text, whatever you are writing. Using word art or with the help of word art, we can make the text look curved, wavy, or apply 3D effects to the text. Let us see how. Go to the insert tab, click on the word art option. Suppose I select this one. This type of this, you can see here, dotted rectangular box within which it is written your text here. Now click here within the placeholder. Delete it with the help of the backspace key and write whatever you want to write. Suppose if I write here, happy. Okay, after writing here happy, what I will do, I will select the text. Okay, now in the text effect, I will go in the word styles. You will see here, children, it is in the format tab. In the word styles group, there is a text effect. After clicking on the text effect, you will get a drop down menu of this type. The first one is the shadow. Let us see what is there in shadow, how the shadow is applied to our text. You can see here, notice the shadow in the text. So now again select the text, children. As many times you want to make changes in your text, that many times you will have to select your text. Now see here, reflection. This is about the reflection. Again, so this is about the reflection and shadow we studied. Now let us learn about more features. That is 3D rotation. See here. This is the 3D rotation. This is the 3D rotation. Now let us see what is more there in the text effect. Select the text, then go to the format tab. You will find here drawing tools. In the drawing tools, come to the word art styles. Notice the movement of the mouse cursor. See here, the text effect is here. Now you can see here transform. This is about the transform. So this way we can make the changes. So this was about the word art, children. Let us come to the next topic, that is the clip art. Clip art, children. Clip art is a gallery of pre-designed pictures that can be inserted directly in a document. You have certain pre-designed pictures in your computer system that can be inserted directly in the document. Let us see how. Again, we will move to the insert tab. In the insert tab, you will see here there is clip art option. Click on this clip art option. After clicking on the clip art option, you will get a dialog box of this type, and there is a search for box mentioned here. Suppose if I want to insert mangoes, what I will do here, I'll click on this picture, particular picture like this, and click on the insert option. You will notice that the mangoes, they are inserted. Now how to adjust it according to your size? The adjustment is known as, children, crop. This way you can crop the picture in your document, or with the help of the double headed arrow, we can drag it and make it according to our choice. You can bring it in the document as per your choice. So this way we can bring it here with the help of the double headed arrow also. See here. So children, this is about the clip art. So children, this was about inserting clip art, inserting word art, and how to change the layout of your slide. So I hope you all must have understood, children. Furthermore topics from the lesson we will discuss in the next video. Till then, practice this. Have a nice day. Thank you.